If you have ever wondered what it takes to get a 9 in GCSE maths, you are at the right video because today I'll be sharing with you all top 10 advanced tips on how to really get that 9 in GCSE maths and how to really smash that exam so that you walk out of it very confidently and proud. So if you're interested to find out the tips, then please keep watching this video till the end. So these 10 tips are all based on three areas. Number one is my own personal mistakes and experience on how I undertook the GCSE maths exam and how I wish I did it differently. Number two, it's based on my own sister's teachers' comments and what it takes to get a 9, so from her school. And number three, it's of course based on research online and YouTube videos that I watched. And all put together, I've created this top 10 advanced tips on how to really get that 9 in GCSE maths. So if you want to jump straight into it, click play. So of course, before I move on to the advanced tips on how to get a 9 in GCSE maths, I want to make sure that you're covering these four basic tips already. First one is making sure that you're looking at the mark scheme, the examiner's reports, as well as the teacher's comments in terms of how to improve your answers and how to really get that 9 in general. So if you're not looking at these resources, then you're really missing out, because these truly give you the golden advices and golden nuggets on how to really get that 9 in maths. So you want to make sure that you're looking at these three resources every time you're completing anything based on maths. Number two is making sure that you're practicing as many past papers as possible, because for maths that's no brainer, and I should not have to explain this that detail because that is very basic. The only way to get a 9 in maths is definitely by practicing. Number three is making sure you're looking at the YouTube resources or any kind of free resources available online to make sure they teach you the content very much so you can look at maybe flashcards like Quizlets or any other free summary sheets or any kind of YouTube videos out there that help you with that. Number four is making sure that you're sending as much as work as possible to your teachers, only if it's applicable, because I understand that maths is not like English where you really have to write your own points and your own evidence and etc etc. So even if you can show to your teachers that you have completed some work at home on your own independently, that can be a really good way to stand out and make your teacher look like that you're putting a lot of hard work. So I'm now going to be moving on to the advanced tips. And the first one that I'm going to be sharing with you all is the fact that you have to print out the specification list or the specification or the syllabus list of all the topics that are guaranteed to be coming up in your exam. And I'm aware that in the UK, you can actually do this where the teachers will exactly tell you what are the topics that are coming up in the exam. And that can be really helpful, first of all, for you to really see which topics that you're finding it very difficult, and you want to tackle those first. This does not mean that you're leaving out all those topics that you're very confident about, but you want to tackle those difficult ones first, because those are going to take time for you to really achieve that confidence level that you can actually do them really easily without having to really worry much. So you want to make sure that you're printing out your syllabus, seeing which topics are very difficult for you, and you're tackling those first whilst also practicing the confident ones that you already know how to do really well. So this is a customized tip from my sister, who's also actually doing her GCSEs, and that is to make a flashcard or a cheat sheet with all kinds of formulas, equations, or any kind of algebraic equation that you might be doing, and you want to put them in a flashcard and know the steps on how to solve them very easily. And it's basically kind of knowing how to solve those questions and knowing the content on how to really solve those things. So in maths, I know it is all about practicing and stuff and how to get the right answer, but you also don't want to forget the content on how to really solve those questions. So I want you to actually make flashcards of each kind of topics, especially the algebraic ones, because in that way you will know exactly what are the steps to actually answer those questions, and number two, you will know exactly the content, so that even if you get a very difficult question in the exam, you will know how to answer it. Tip number three is making sure that you're making up your own questions and answering them, and in a way you're creating your own past paper. In this way, first of all, testing your own knowledge, number two, you're applying the knowledge, and number three, you're also getting to use active recall to make sure that you can answer also difficult questions as well that you may have not have ever seen before, because in the exam usually they will give you questions that you may have never seen before as well. So you want to attempt as many different kinds of styles of the same topic in different kinds of ways that might be presented to you for you to answer. So you want to make sure that you're creating your own past paper in a nutshell. Tip number four is making sure that you're taking all tests or any kind of assessment that you might be taking right now in your school to be taken very, very seriously till your end of your exam or the end of your year, because this is very, very important. because when you are taking up all your tests and whatever tests you might be given, that might be added to your final grade that you might be getting for your GCSE maths. So you want to make sure that you are well prepared in all kinds of tests and you do not take them lightly in a way, and you take them as a real exam almost and try to attempt them and revise for them as if though you are going to be having the real exam that you may have had if there was no COVID-19. So you want to prepare for each kind of test in a very well structured and organized manner, and making sure that you're not cramming for these, because that's not a really good idea for anyone anyways, and even if it is, it's for only for a small percentage of people. So, and you don't want to take that risk on testing out if you're those 1% of people. So you want to make sure that you're well organized and well structured, and you start revising as early as possible and take all these tests very, very seriously. Tip number 5 is making sure that you have a study group or a group of classmates where you can rely on whenever you don't understand a question or you don't understand a topic, and you can actually rely on them to make sure they can explain back to you and teach it back to you. And you also can teach it back to them whenever they don't understand something. In that way, you're creating like a small study group in a way, and in that way you can help each other out to get that 9 as well, because we all want to be helping each other up here and try to be the best version and students as much as possible. So I believe that having a study group can be very useful in terms of subjects like maths, physics, or anything like that. So you want to have as much support as possible, especially if the teachers out there might be very busy and might not give you the time and might be unavailable to really help you. So in that situation, having friends and having classmates or a study group can really help you to achieve the best grade as possible in your next test. I would say tip number 6 is probably the most important one, and it's that it is okay if you don't understand a topic right away and it takes you time to really understand that topic, because as a student who has been really weak in maths myself, this has been a very big challenge for me, because I wouldn't understand topics right away as my peers would or my friends would very easily. So you want to make sure that you're telling yourself that it is okay if you're taking time to actually understand a topic, and it's not the end of the world in a way, because everybody has different capabilities and different level of understanding on a subject. You might be really good at English, but another person might not be good at it, and vice versa for maths as well. So you want to make sure that you're taking your time understanding, and this is why it's very important for you to start very, very early on, so that you can know exactly which topics you're very difficult finding it difficult or you need time to actually understand, and in that way you'll be able to achieve a really good grade at the end, because then you have tackled both difficult and the confident topics all together, and hopefully you will achieve a 9 at the end. This brings me to the end of today's video. I hope you really enjoyed and found this video really helpful for you in terms of GCSE maths and how to get a 9 in that subject, because I know how difficult maths can be for some people, as it was for me as well. So I hopefully think that these tips have really helped you. If it did, then please like, share and subscribe to this YouTube channel, because I will be uploading GCSE related videos this whole entire month. So you want to stay tuned for whichever subject that you might need help on. I'm there for you and I'll be helping you out. And other than that, subscribe to this channel, because I post also law related productivity as well as self-growth kind of videos as well. But other than that, I will see you in my next week's video.